Hey guys, what is up? It is Chris 60. Welcome into the channel. It's called How to Get Your Dream Girl. Techniques and strategies for getting that one girl you really want. If it's your first time here, hit subscribe and you won't miss a video. Let's get into it. So today I want to talk about when you are in some kind of relationship with a woman and things are going good, but then all of a sudden something happens and you're shocked and you can't believe it because things have changed. How do you handle it? Well, I've been noticing a lot this week with my clients. When something comes up, they overreact. I'm going to give you a few examples. So let's say that you're dating a girl and you get the, I need some space, I need time, maybe we should date other people. You hear that and you react, okay? Right away. Maybe you react by running over to her house with your guitar and you're going to sing a song and try to get her back. Or maybe you react by trying to convince her that she's wrong and she's making a mistake and she should stay with you because you are the greatest for her. She doesn't even know. You plead your case. Okay? There's a problem with this, and it's not what you think. The problem is, besides that, it's going to lower her interest more, is she hasn't proven she can stay away from you, that she can be apart from you, right? She made her move. She made her statement, I need time, I need space, but she has not proven it, right? So the key is you're not supposed to react because nothing has happened yet. She hasn't proven the concept. She hasn't gone a week, a month, 6 weeks, 2 months away from you. She hasn't proven she can do it. She's made her move, but that doesn't mean you have to make yours right now. You don't rush in. You don't make your chess move right after hers and say, well, no, I'm coming over right now. No, 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 just think about this. Hold on, let's talk. You don't do that, right? You just have the mindset of, let me see you prove it. So your response would be, okay, I need space, I need time, okay, cool. Or I was thinking the same thing or anything along the lines, right? Because she hasn't proven it. Let her prove it for a week, let her prove it for 2 weeks, 3 weeks. There's no need to do anything because she hasn't proven it. Now, a week or two in, if you haven't gone over there and begged her to stay, she should start missing you. And then it starts the process of her coming back to you, right? Because she hasn't proven it. Now, it's the same thing if, let's say you're in a casual relationship, right? And she says, well, I think we should go back to being friends, right? She made her move. You want to react and make your move. I can't be your friend. I'm no friend. I'm a lover. Why are you making a move? Why are you reacting? She hasn't proven it yet. If she goes weeks or a month keeping to this we're just friends thing, then you can worry. Then you can adjust and make your move. Then you can say, you know what? I really don't want to be just friends with you. We were more than friends and I'm not comfortable with this friends thing. Now you make your move. You've waited because odds are you just go, okay. And a week or two later, she's messaging you because listen, nobody has self-control nowadays anyway. No one can wait. Well, we think we should just be friends. A week later, hey, what are you doing? Right? But when you react or put on the tough guy act, I'm not a friend. I'm no wimp. I'm not your friend. You lose, right? You reacted right away. Instead, again, the mindset is let her prove it. Let's see if you can prove it. Let's see if you can go a week, a month without me, right? Without me contacting you, without us hanging out. Let's see you prove it. So that's why you say, okay, when they come up with this stuff, let's see if they can prove it. Prove the concept, then I'll worry, right? Because I don't think you can, because I don't think you can walk away. And that's why you don't overreact or beg them to stay or run over there with your banjo and play a song, okay? You don't need to do that. What guys are doing with the walking away, they're making it too dramatic. And I've seen that a lot in my coaching this week. So what do I mean by that? So they walk away and all the gifts they gave the girl gave them, that they returned them and put it on her desk. Well, I guess you want your picture frame back. Dramatic. Why are you doing that? Or they meet up to exchange items. Well, I'm going to come over. I know my lawnmower is still over there, so I'm going to come over Wednesday. Why are you doing that? Why are you making the walking away into a big dramatic thing? Why are you making the breakup seem more real than it has to be? Right? It's only real if you're making it real. Why are you making this so official? I have to come up and pick up my books, so I'm going to come to your house. You're making it dramatic, right? Don't walk away with drama. Don't walk away with, I just can't take this anymore, so I'm walking away. It hurts me. No. It's got to be calm, and you got to take the emotion out of it. You can't be too dramatic walking away. Want to learn how to get your dream girl? The Dream Girl Formula book has finally been released, containing 20 years of secrets that I've learned from coaching guys how to get the girl of their dreams. Click the link below to learn more and start reading.